Hey guys, my name is Vitas and I'm a content manager at Oxylabs. In this video, we're gonna talk about proxy types. But before we do, let's quickly touch on the IP address for all of this to make sense. So here's a random IP address that I wrote down earlier. Basically, all the devices on the internet carries one. It's a necessity to communicate with other internet resources. But here's the catch. The IP address carries quite a lot of sensitive information. For instance, it's possible to locate you, sometimes even to a street level. For that very reason, and you know, for any other reason, if you want to stay anonymous online, you would employ a proxy. So a proxy is a substitute, if you like. It carries its own IP address and gives you the anonymity online. When it comes to proxy types, there's quite a few of them, but in this video, we're going to touch the most common ones. So let's start off with data center proxies. Data center proxies are artificial. They are stored in data centers all around the world. They're actually hugely popular between businesses that practice web scraping. Let me quickly demonstrate you how it works. So if you're a client and you have a target of your choice, a data source, a website, instead of connecting to it directly and showing your IP address, you would employ proxies. So proxies sit somewhere in the middle. As I mentioned, they carry their own IP address, so you would reroute it, collect the data, and it would go back to you. Your IP address is here, hidden. So that's pretty much how web scraping works in simplest terms. So data center proxies are fast, they offer stable performance, but as I mentioned, they are artificial. So websites can actually identify them, and by doing so, block the access to their website. For that very reason, businesses employ residential proxies as well for more challenging targets. So residential proxies are legit IPs. They're real IPs attached to a physical location. When you connect to the website through residential proxy, the website will think that a human being is actually surfing the net and won't block it. And then you can just collect the data successfully back to you. Now, taking a step even further, proxies can be shared, semi-dedicated, or private. So a shared proxy means that a lot of users are using it at the same time. That means the performance is shared between everyone. Semi-dedicated proxies are used between 3 to 5 users and usually, designed for specific tasks online. So it's definitely an upgrade. And lastly, there's private proxies, also known as dedicated proxies. These type of proxies, that means all the performance at your end, you can do whatever you like with it. And that's what we sell here at Oxylabs. All of our proxies are dedicated private just for one customer. So that's pretty much it. We covered it all. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, hit the subscribe button. Other than that, if you have questions on proxies or Oxylabs, leave a comment down below and I'll do my best to answer them. Thanks for watching, have a great day, all the best.